Welcome back to GM Sports. Time now for Gimme 5, sponsored by ComEd. And joining us in studio tonight, Bears running back, great, and one of my favorite running backs of all time, Matt Forte, is here. Thank you for stopping by, sir.
Yeah, thanks for having me, man. It's a blessing.
It's a blessing, man. Listen, we're going to talk about your new project that you have and your book coming up. But first, we got to talk some Bears while you're here.
Yeah.
You know this franchise. Everybody has been waiting. Every single year, everybody's waiting. This seems like I've never seen the anticipation of a year like this year with Caleb Williams, this new-look offense, and also a defense coming up from last season that was strong. How excited are you for this season?
I mean, you see me, I got my Bears hat on already. We got Sunday coming up soon. It's game week, so I'm excited, man. I've been telling a lot of the fans who see me around the city or have asked me questions about the team that I'm super excited. This is the most excited I've been in a long time since I've actually played with the Bears. But at the same time, I've always told them to relax a little bit too, because they still have to go out there and play. They still have to, you know, get things done on the field. And this is a great situation for Caleb to come into. One of the most talented offenses, player-wise, on paper, which doesn't mean much when you say on paper. But at the same time, you've got, you know, receivers all over the place who have 1,000-yard seasons, and especially with veteran presence, and then a rookie receiver who did some stuff in college who, you know, is looking, obviously, you've seen in preseason with the throws that have been made and the over-the-shoulder catches. I'm excited about all of that. But I've played here for a while, and I know defense does win championships. It's funny, coming from an offensive guy, defense does win championships, though. I played on some teams with some struggling offenses, but our defense was insane. And we went deep into the playoffs. So I'm excited most about the increase that the defense has had from last year at the end of the season, and the way that they've, you know, the turnovers that they've gotten, the kind of shutdown on the corners, the pressure on the quarterback. Those things are what makes a team, you know, win games.
I know we always talk about tight ends or being a quarterback's, like, safety blanket or a good run game, but it is. This defense could be just what the doctor ordered for Caleb Williams to be able to create those takeaways and also shorten the field just a little bit. So it's going to be interesting to see if this defense can pick up where they left off last season.
Yeah, I don't want them to get so excited about the passing game and just forget about the running game. I am a running back, so I got to represent
I'm surrounded by two running backs here, so you knew that was coming.
I got to represent for DeAndre and also Roshan, those guys, because, I mean, you have kind of a good dynamic right there with a guy who is shifty and DeAndre who can get in the passing game and do some stuff. Sure, Roshan can as well, but he's more of a bigger back who can run between the tackles. So that is a great safety blanket for a rookie quarterback as well. A great defense, hard-nosed defense, and running the ball is going to be key, especially late in the season when it gets cold out there and you're on Soldier Field. It's not, we don't play in a dome. It's not turf out there. So
not yet.
You're going to have to run. Yeah, not yet. So until then, we got to run the ball a lot and get used to that early in the season so that it's not something new. I've been in situations like that where we get this new, you know, toy on offense, and the coordinator comes in, he gets really excited, and it's like, well, that's when we airing it out. I remember one season, I think it was the 100-plus catches I had. I think in the first three games, I had 30-plus catches. I was leading the league in receiving. I'm like, well, we're throwing the ball way too much if that's the problem right there. So I think our offensive coordinator needs to, you know, relax and play a balanced game, because balanced offenses and hard-nosed defense is what really carries the team.
I had seen back in May when the Bears had their gala, you and a few former Bears players spoke to the rookies, Caleb Williams, Romo Odunze. What message did you want to share with them? What were those conversations like?
I was really casual. You know, we didn't want to, you know, hit them with too much because they got stuff coming from them, you know, at them everywhere. You know, it really was just saying, like, this city is here for the taking. The city is yours, and you have the keys to it, so drive it well. And at the same time, respect it. Respect the fans, you know, the loyalty that they show. And, you know, win, lose, or draw, they're always out there, and they're always rooting for us. So, and then go out there and play lights out, play hard. Every time I've seen someone in retirement, I've been retired 6 years now, they always say, man, we appreciate how hard you played, even if you were losing the game or out of the playoffs or whatever. And, you know, that was one of the things. That's just a character thing. And so they received that well, and it to me it looked like they were, you know, primed and ready and have been kind of a message that has been throughout the facility, yeah, that, hey, you know, this is a team that needs to have good character integrity first, because, you know, on the field and off the field, they coincide.
I don't know if you're like us, but we watch Hard Knocks and just like, okay, so you get it. But that's what conveys from the message that you see from that. To me, it's about Ryan Poles. It starts at the top and seeing what kind of GM he is and a guy that really cares for these players. What's been your take on seeing him kind of revamp this whole entire roster, but also the way that he is amongst those players and how they look at him?
Yeah, I love his approach. You know, Ryan and I were same draft class. He was undrafted, but we were in camp together, and I love his approach towards the game. He respects the game. He respects players. He respects – there's no hierarchy in there where you treat one guy differently than another. And you can see, even if you've watched Hard Knocks, that – you know, even on cut day, he was there. He know he was in those shoes before, and it was a respect thing as well. So I think that goes a long way when you're a GM and you treat the players in a way that is humanistic. It's not like you're just a mm-hmm. part and a piece of the team and, you know, thanks for your service, see you mm-hmm. later. So that part meant more to me than the football things. And also the moves that he's continued to make, he's very strategic. In it. And you see that a lot of thought goes into it. He has a lot of good counsel around him, and that's what you need to be a good GM in this league.
They showed some old footage from him at that 08 camp as well on Hard Knocks. That was probably pretty cool to see. Rex Grossman was there. You were out there, obviously, as well. Before we get to the book, when you talk about expectations, and you've told Bears fans, look, you got to be a little cautious because it is still a rookie, but it's a circumstance unlike most first-round draft picks, number one overall draft picks, will never get, being on this team with so much talent. What would you say are reasonable expectations for the Bears in 2024?
You know, the Bears are my team. You know, they drafted me, and I'm always going to give them the benefit of the doubt. So I'm going to say above 500.
Okay.
I'm going to say above 500. 10 games.
Okay.
I'm with you. 10-7.
I'm gonna give them 10 games. And yeah, I say that because these games come down really to, especially these divisional games. I mean, they come down to such a minute, really difference of win and lose. And I think this team has a good culture that Coach Eberflus has created that and continues to do that. And that they're super talented. And I think they have enough talent to really take them if they play together. And you know, make the most of the opportunities that they're given out there.
It's got Matt Forte sitting up here with us. And we got Matt Forte. Can we talk about the book?
And a special guest you brought with you
because
it's a book, My Hair Can. It's written by Matt Forte, but also your daughter Nala is a co-author, and she is with us as well. You got the book here, Nala.
Yeah.
This is awesome. First, share the experience of writing this together as a father and a daughter, and Nala, what this was like to write this book with your dad.
It was really cool to at least have a book that actually told something about like how like my hair can do this and my hair can do that, and to have a book that teaches people and little girls about how Jesus gave them their hair, and it's a blessing, and to love Jesus. Yeah,
that's awesome. Yeah. And Dad, I know it has to be special for you. Yeah. But now to be able, this seems like a long process for you, something that you have for a little bit, and now it's actually coming. How does it feel to actually see it in your hand?
It is definitely surreal to see this come to fruition. And, man, it was a seed that was planted a long time ago. Nala was much younger than she is now. She's 11. She was probably, you know, 7 or 8 when I first wrote this. And it came out of a little bit of pain. Like a lot of times a seed is planted out of pain, but then it produces something that's beautiful. And that's what happened with this. You know, a comment was made at school about her skin color and her hair. And as a dad and a former football player, I have a tendency to get aggressive.
Yeah.
And I was like, man, I was hot. You know, I was mad. And I wanted to make a positive out of a negative, and to show her that, you know, the world may tell you this and tell you that, but only the one who created you can tell you who you really are. And so that was my goal in doing it. Wrote it, you know, 4 or 5 years ago, and it sat in my phone. And due to a friend of mine, Esau McCauley, who is an author himself, he introduced me to Tyndale and Tyndale Kids, and they picked the book up, and it's continued to grow. And I just, my hope for the book is that, in America and in this culture, the hair of, you know, colored people and just, it's kind of been, we've been beat up about it. You know, you have to look a certain way to be in corporate, or you have to, you know, to the kid who's a wrestler and he has to cut his locks off that he's been growing his whole life because it's a distraction in wrestling. And, you know, you see it in sports, you see it in the corporate world, you see it all over the place that sometimes you can't be your authentic self because, and that causes, you know, issues, you know, and how you view yourself, how you look in the mirror and how you see yourself. And my hope for the book is that, you know, people who, you know, may have gone through some trauma like that or some issues, they really can look in the mirror and say, this is the way I've been created. I love how I look, and I can love other people because I love myself.
I love that word authenticity that you use as well, embracing yourself, your heritage, your story as well. Where can folks get the book if they want to purchase it online or at a bookstore?
Yeah, all the bookstores.
All the bookstores.
And, you know, obviously everybody goes to Amazon. Amazon is carrying the book, and it's available in Spanish on October 1st.
Oh, great.
So it's My Hair Can and Mi Cabello Puede.
Matt, appreciate you. Nala, appreciate you as
Nala,
well.
Appreciate you guys it. Are, Matt, you guys congratulations awesome. On the book, guys. And looking forward to bear season. Here
yes,
we go.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
All right, we got to take a break. When we come back, we got more for you here on GN Sports. Don't go anywhere. Stay with us. Matt Forte is here. It's coming up next here on GN Sports.